The fundamental milestone in the life of the visually impaired is rehabilitation. The National Association for the Blind, that is NAB, and such other institutions play an important role in this sphere. This process of rehabilitation helps those people who have lost their sight as a result of accidents, as well as those who are born blind. The main endeavor of this program is to rehabilitate those people whose attitudes, surroundings, outlook, different actions and reactions, and in other words, every aspect of life has changed on account of their blindness.
The mission of NAB is to make sure that visually impaired people become independent enough to do all their daily chores on their own, safely handle various tasks in their home or outside, and chiefly to guide them in finding suitable occupation and become self-sufficient. This section rehabilitates those who have a fruitless existence and helps them transform their lives. The people who are here will step into the world with a positive outlook towards life, and once they develop this self-confidence, there is no turning back.
Hey Prabhu Ananda Data,
Jnanam ko dijiye,
Shigra sare durgunon ko,
Dur humse kijiye,
लीजिए हमको शरण में
हम सदाचारी बने
ब्रह्मचारी धर्म रक्षक
वीरव्रतधारी बने
These programs can be divided into three levels: basic, social, and occupational.
The basic level includes training in daily chores like stitching, ironing, independently moving around at home and outside, cooking, and basically doing one's tasks by oneself. When we train them to work in the kitchen, explaining safety norms becomes very important. For instance, safety norms to be adhered to while working with the gas stove, the kind of clothes to wear in the kitchen, the location of kitchen articles and objects.
On a social level, they are taught to read and write Braille, identify currency, social behavior, that is socializing with people and common etiquette, walking safely on roads, and other necessary norms of life. They are taught certain techniques and methods to acquire proficiency in these skills, like the sighted guided technique, the protective technique, and the cane technique. A sighted person helps the visually impaired person to cross the road or to reach his destination in this technique. The sighted person strides ahead and the blind person walks behind, holding his hand in this manner. A word of caution, however. There should be only one or two blind people with a single sighted person, or else there is a danger of an accident occurring. This technique is helpful in making walking in the road easier and safer for the blind people. After this comes the protective technique. It has two main parts. The upper arm technique is a technique to protect the region from the chest to the head. On the other hand, the lower arm technique protects the lower region from the waist to the feet. This technique is used by the blind people while picking up items from the ground at home, office, and institutions. We will now understand the cane technique. This technique is used by the visually impaired to walk with the aid of a cane.
Blindness is no longer an impediment in their path towards progress. In addition to all this, the rehabilitation center also takes care of their entertainment. They are taught to play games like carom, chess, cards, etc. In addition to these means of entertainment, the physical fitness levels of the visually impaired people are also monitored. Along with these subjects, the rehabilitation center also focuses on guidance in cottage industries. This guidance is given so that they have an ongoing source of income when they leave from here before they find stable employment while working from home.
They are taught to make agarbattis, chairs, brooms, paper bags, pack popcorn and other such small activities. Where to procure the raw material required for these enterprises, how to package these articles and how to market them is also taught during this training.
मेरा नाम राजू कृष्णा गावड़े है. मेरा क्वालिफिकेशन 10th पास है. हम पहला मेरा शिक्षण ये पहले साइटेड में हुआ, लेकिन एक्सीडेंट की वजह से मेरी आँख की नस ये दब गई, इसलिए मुझे ब्लाइंडनेस आ गया. और मैं महालक्ष्मी के 82 के बैच में प्रशिक्षण लिया. उस प्रशिक्षण की वजह से मैं अपने खुद के पैरों पर खुद खड़ा रहा.
मेरा नाम राजू चौहान है और मैं TYBA तक होते तक मेरा साइड नॉर्मल था, और बाद में मैं सल्पा टैबलेट के रिएक्शन से ब्लाइंड बना. जब उस समय मुझे लगा था कि अभी मेरी ज़िंदगी रुक गई, पर एक गृहस्थ से मुझे इस संस्था की जानकारी मिली और 4 जनवरी 2001 के 82 बैच में मैंने इस संस्था का 4 महीने का ट्रेनिंग पूरा किया. और ट्रेनिंग पूरा करने में मेरे इस ट्रेनिंग में मुझे बहुत बड़ा आत्मविश्वास और मैं अपने पैरों पर खड़ा हो सका.
मेरा एजुकेशन मैंने कॉलेज किया, उसके बाद डीजल मैकेनिक का कोर्स करके मैंने मेरा सिप का बिजनेस चालू किया. उसके बाद मेरे को ये ब्लाइंडनेस, जब मैं स्टॉप पे खड़ा था, जब भी मैंने दूसरे को मैंने बस नंबर पूछा तो वो आदमी मेरे ऊपर गुस्सा हो गया कि आप इतने अच्छे दिखते हो और अच्छे एजुकेटेड लगते हो, मगर अपने मेरे को नंबर क्यों पूछा. वो गुस्से से पागल हो गया, मगर मेरे को मैं क्या बोला अभी उनको मैं समझ में नहीं आया मेरे, क्योंकि मेरे को सचमुच दिख ही नहीं रहा था. उसके बाद मेरे को दियोर में आके मैंने इधर बताया कि मैं ऐसा ऐसा प्रॉब्लम है, तो यहाँ आके मेरे को चलना फिरना, आज लोगों की मदद कैसे लेनी है, ये सब सिखाया गया. और अपने पैरों के ऊपर खड़ा रह के मेरे मन में जो आत्मविश्वास निर्माण किया गया, और उसके बाद नियाप तरफ मेरे को PCO बूथ मिला के आज मैं अपने पैरों के ऊपर खड़ा रह के अपना कुटुंब और सब कुछ मैं कर सकता हूँ, और मैं अभी खुशी हूँ.
And this advancement is extremely useful in enhancing their economic status. In this way, there is an improvement in the efficiency of a blind person apart from personality development. During the course of the rehabilitation program, a complete check is maintained on the activities of all the participants. Depending on one's IQ levels, flexibility and taste, the participants are given appropriate professional guidance and help.
To test the IQ, a kit based on the touch and feel principle is provided. This is a test of geometric analysis. His IQ depends on how fast he can make this geometrical figure. For finger sensitivity test, pieces with different roughness are given. They are asked to arrange them in the order of their roughness. Time is the most important factor in this.
The duration of this rehabilitation program is 4 months. This program is conducted thrice annually, out of which one program is exclusively meant for women. On the completion of this program, each student gets busy in his daily routine. He becomes self-sufficient and is infused with a fresh energy. The pessimistic outlook and melancholy towards life comes to an end. But this journey does not end here, since this is the first stepping stone towards making them independent. In our next program, we will get to know more about some professions, the courses for which are conducted by NAB. These are instrumental in not only making them self-sufficient, but also help them in supporting their family. Thank you.